to deny people their human rights is to challenge their very humanity. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights is the most precious achievement of humanity. This declaration has been composed by delegates from different walks of life who came together on the 10th of December, 1948, with a simple but challenging purpose: make this world a better place. And by doing that, they vowed themselves to protect each and every human being on this planet. But today, after nearly 70 years of trying so hard to accomplish that dream, is every person given the gift of security? In other words, is every person receiving their basic rights? To begin with, what are human rights about? Violence? War? Definitely not. Human rights are about peace. Human rights are about tolerance. Human rights are also about love, equality, brotherhood, kindness, and many more values that are pinned on the ground. Children who are lucky enough to get an average education are taught at school that intimidation must be stopped, that compulsion must be banned. But how are they supposed to believe that when everything we are encountering in our daily lives is news about war, robbery, or even murder? According to the first article of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, all human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. They are endowed with reason and conscience and should act towards one another in a spirit of brotherhood. So let's take a moment and think about it. Children in Africa are unschooled or left on the streets to face a destiny bigger than their abilities to survive. Black people in mixed communities are facing on a daily basis physical abuse and insults related to the color of their skin. Poor people in undeveloped countries are either dying from hunger or trying so hard to survive by succumbing to sleep. Moreover, women all over the world are battling gender inequality. Violence against women is most pervasive. The massive violation of human rights throughout the world is a matter of great shame. We might not come across a black person, an abused child, or a poverty-stricken person in our daily lives. But what we are all sure of is that no day can pass without having to talk to a woman. Whether in the street, in a grocery shop, in a formal conference, or at the hospital, women are present. Statistics show that women constitute nearly half of the world's population. Doesn't that mean that women constitute nearly half of our communities? What these percentages really mean is that women are everywhere, at any time. And in order for them to be more productive, they should be protected from any form of inequality. Unfortunately, even in the most advanced societies, women are denied their basic right. What's more, let's not forget that every single one of us came to this world because of a woman. And thanking them the way most people do is shameful. Studies show that women are able to excel in much more fields than men do, only if they had the chance to speak their minds. All in all, I care for human rights, because being human is partly about caring for others. But most importantly, I care for them because I'm convinced to, and not because I have to. However, caring for them isn't the most essential part. Working for them is. So let's change it from "I care for human rights" to "I work for human rights." And thank you.